Hey folks, Kel here again. Well, you saw me do a box opening on this watch, and I never intended to have that watch, my Seiko 715. I never intended to use this with that metal band I had. It's kind of an attractive band. I'm just not sure it fits me very well. When I was looking at this watch, I gotta say, by the way, I forgot to mention that video. I bought this for $175. These go for almost $400. You see, maybe for like $388 and stuff like that. And I found one on. I didn't intend to buy a watch. Couldn't really afford to buy one, actually. Couldn't afford to spend the money. But I saw one of these on on Amazon for $175, and I bought it. In fact, it said last one, and I bought the darn thing. This is a few months ago now. This is after Christmas. And then what I did is I looked around for several months for a watch band for it. I wanted to get a real alligator. Because I saw a photo online when I was saving photos of this watch in anticipation of buying one. I saw photos of this watch online with leather alligator bands on. I like alligator anyway. I'm a big fan of alligator watch bands anyway. And I found this one here. I saw a watch like this with this band. I don't know if my camera's going to do the proper thing here. Maybe it will. And I just thought it looked wonderful. Not this exact band, of course, but a band like this. And I actually looked around and I found a bunch of bands, real alligator skin bands in Vietnam, from Vietnam. And they actually are a real alligator or crocodile. It's actually crocodile, I think. And they're like $20, $30, not $275 like you are here sometimes. So I thought I would just, I got, this is the band I've been wanting to have, and I finally got the band in. And it's on. Let me put it on here for you. Sorry about that. Gonna put the band on. There you go. There's the band. That looks real good on there. I think it looks really good on there. I think it's good, a good looking band. I think that this band looks especially good with I had a black. I had a leather faux alligator band for a while. I put on this. Actually, I think I took it off. I think I took it off that Ericsson watch I had. It's the same width here. These, I think this is 19, I don't know, 20 millimeters width watch band. I think it looks really good. I always want a nice dress watch. I haven't used this watch for anything. I will save this for if I go on some kind of a date with some girl out to a dinner somewhere, which is unlikely because I'm not dating right now. But if I did, I would wear this watch. This would be a good watch, I think, for a nice little classy date, go out to dinner somewhere. So there's some nice restaurants here where I live, so it'd be kind of nice. But there it is. I said I'd show it to you. I like this watch. It has a little date thing down here at the bottom. I don't know right now if it's correct. Let me see if it's correct. Yeah, that's why I don't like having date functions on the watch. You can see a month or two goes by and it stops being correct. It says 21 when it's actually the 22nd. But anyway, still looks good, doesn't it, though? Nice little watch. This band was like, I think $20, $25 or something. That's pretty cheap for a real crocodile band. But there it is. I told you I'd show it to you. I think these watches look great with a crocodile band. I think they look really good this way. I really do. I love the fact that, again, this band has this little detail, little winder protectors or whatever. Just the way it looks here. And with the croco band on, I like the space they have here. Little knobs right here at the end of this part right there. It looks very antique to me. It looks like something out of the 20s or 30s, which is, I've always felt like I was born in a previous life in the Victorian era or something like that. Been that feeling my entire life. That's why I smoked a pipe for so long and still do once in a while. Because then cigars, because it harkens back to that Sherlock Holmes type era. And watches like this kind of look a bit antique to me too. But there it is. There's my little 715. And it's a Seiko, which I really like Seiko. So there it is. I think a leather watch band looks good in a watch, especially a crocodile watch band. My favorite watch I wore with a crocodile watch band. My little Seiko Daytona, I wore that with a crocodile watch band for years. Now it's got a, like a bond type strap on it, but I wore it with a crocodile band for years. Well, that's it. That's the I was telling you about getting this with a leather crocodile type band. That's the band I got. And I'm not generally I don't generally wear brown, but and I think of crocodiles as brown. So it makes sense, I guess. And the first picture I ever saw this watch with a crocodile type band, it was a brown band, so I don't know, it looks kind of good on there. I'll wear it this way. All right, folks, well, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. And I will talk to you later. You know what, also, let's keep it proper time. Yeah, let's keep it proper time because it's, no, it's not. No, I didn't set this for daylight savings time, or non-daylight savings time, so. I hate that damn daylight savings time. Every year I got to resell my damn watches. All right, well, I'll talk to you later. Hope you're having a good one. Bye. Oh, by the way, before I leave, if I still have the link, check out Clockwork Synergy for their bands. You can get 10% off there. We're using my link, which I'll put in the description if I'm still doing that. I haven't used the link yet, so I'm not sure they're still doing that with me, but I think they are. I didn't make some videos when I showed it a few months ago, so I'm not sure if they forgot about me or not. But if they haven't, check the link. And even if they have forgot about me, they're still best place to buy watch bands, in my opinion. They're reasonable priced, and they're nice, and free shipping, all that good stuff. All right, well, I will talk to you later, guys.